Good morning, YouTube. So I'm getting ready to put together some of these battery holders to make my version of Paul Kennett's power shelf. So I'll be putting 3 4-cell holders together. It gives me 12 battery slots. I'll only be using 10 of them. But I wanted some way to hold these together before I solder them onto the nickel strip. So what I'll do is I'll solder the negative terminals to the nickel strip, put another holder here, then I'll solder wires from these terminals, the positive terminals, over to the strip, and that'll be my fuse wires. And I was looking for some way to hold these together. You know, I could probably use some glue, but then you have to try to somehow clamp these parts together. And I was looking here, you have these two little slots there that line up, and these are common on a lot of these 4-cell holders. They all have those same little slots, so I imagine those must be there for a reason. I don't know what they use them for. If you put those slots together, it's about 8 millimeters this way. They're about 7 millimeters this way, and they're just short of 4 millimeters deep. So I got some measurements, punched it into Fusion 360, and I made myself a couple little blocks, 8 millimeters, 7, and about 4 millimeters tall there. And interestingly, I printed these with a brim. I've left the brim on. The parts are spaced just right, and you can just do that. You got one. You take the next one over. So the easiest way to do these is just put them down on a hard surface. You gotta get them lined up there. There we go. And there you go. Now I got an 8-cell holder. Do it one more time. I've got 12 cells. I printed 8 of them. Took 23 minutes to print and about 4 grams of filament. So very economical. And I don't think I need to use any glue because by the time I solder one side of these to the strip, I think that's going to hold it pretty solidly in place. And then I'll take these assembled 12-cell holders, and then I'll probably glue them down to a board and use that for my battery holders. So I'll cut in a clip of the printing of these 8. And the trick is, when you lay them out to print, you want them far enough apart that the brims don't overlap. Print, scrape them off the bed, and then they go right into the part. There's no cleanup required. I'll upload these to Thingiverse and put a link to that page in the video description if you're looking to join up some 4-cell 18650 holders. And here's a different variety of holder, but they all seem to be this same part number here. This one has wires and not the PCB pins, but they all have this same BH18650 PC8 and then Blossom. I wonder if that's the name of the company that makes these injection molded parts. And then they just put different spring terminals in there. These have the wires soldered to the tops, and then they're cut flush on the bottom. And then these don't have any wires, but they have the pins sticking out. So yeah, that worked really well. You're looking at joining some of these 4-cell holders together. That's a good way to go to stick them together. I did them in ABS. You could probably do them in PLA as well. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll do another video when I get these 4 sets of 12 cell holders soldered on. I'll solder them on to the ground strips first, and then we will go on to the next step of the project. So if you want to check out that video, you can subscribe to the channel for updates. And as always, thanks for watching.